Hi, I'm Raymond Daigle. I'm here at the Sonoma International Film Festival. And right at the moment, I'm sitting here up on stage with Kimberley Buchanan.
Yes.
Your film is Harpooned Soul, the Jade Bell story.
Yes.
Please tell us a little bit about it.
This is a story that took us about 3 years to actually shoot. It's about drug addiction and the perils of what it actually does to a family and how it breaks down a person's entire life. Jade did a heroin speedball over 10 years ago and ended up blind, immobile, and mute, and can now only communicate through the paddles in his wheelchair. And so what he's done is he's taken this mission to go into schools and deliver this message that you really need to choose creativity over drug use. And he wished he had that opportunity when he was a kid, because he just went down the wrong path.
Having not actually seen this film, I've seen the trailer, and the trailer itself packs a huge emotional wallop. I mean, just even thinking about what it's going to be like seeing this film, I feel like I have to prepare myself. It seems like, of all the films I've previewed, this really strikes me as the most humanitarian and thought-provoking film.
Oh, thank you. Well, I really hope it delivers that. I mean, for us, it was a journey going on this with him, to experience how difficult his life is every day, and that he's actually done this to himself.
Yeah.
And his cognizant brain is 100%. So he is locked in this body that can't respond or do anything. And for him to now deliver this message to kids that this actually can happen to you. You know, he thought he could beat it. This was his third overdose. He wasn't a rookie. Third overdose. And when he actually came out of the coma totally fine, and then slipped back into a coma, and that's when the dire, woke up immobile, blind, and mute.
Wow.
Yeah, and so, I mean, that's pretty profound.
I would say so, yes. Where do I even begin? So you are an actress. Besides being a producer, you also act in film.
Yes.
And I'm curious, what drew you? How did you find your way to this project?
Well, documentary film is my passion. I don't think there's a more powerful medium out there today than documentary film. And I think now, finally, documentary films are getting the accolades that they need.
Mm-hmm.
News today is very skewed. And so I think Documentary films actually gives the audience a much better perspective on real issues that are happening today. So with this, it's like really the face of drug addiction. You know, Nancy Reagan can say no forever, but when you see a story like Jade Bell, which resonates with you, and you see this guy and his life and what has happened to him, it's going to impact you a lot more than someone just saying no. And I think that's the beauty of documentary films, and that is my absolute passion. You know, I host TV, I do things like that, but what absolutely jazzes me is documentaries.
And how long did you spend on this project?
This was a 3-year adventure.
Wow.
And it was ups and downs, and it was a roller coaster. I mean, he's tenacious. He would never have survived as long as he has if he was an easy person.
Mm-hmm.
He's a very difficult personality, and we had our toils and tribulations. But, you know, in the end, it's just so worth getting this message out to as many kids as we can.
Sure.
I mean, Jade's already seen hundreds of thousands of kids. He's impacted their lives. They email him. He's already saved lives through his message.
Mm-hmm.
And so for us to be able to create a film around this, we were hoping that we would be able to get it to a much larger audience where it could impact kids all over the world.
And what kind of reception has the film received?
It's had really great response, actually. You know, it's funny when you're in a project, you get so involved and it's just so deep in what our experience. You almost need that outside perspective to understand how it's impacting other people.
Mm.
Because it becomes your life. You know, 3 years of a project.
Sure, sure.
It's really hard to get that true perspective.
And I've asked a couple other documentary filmmakers this, but as you know, documentary film is so much more an organic journey than standard narrative filmmaking. How has this experience changed you? When you went into this you dump yourself out 3 years later, having spent so much time with Jade. How has it changed your view of the world?
I think the biggest thing that really impacted me was looking at someone who has so little in a lot of ways, because mm-hmm. he can only mm-hmm. communicate in such a difficult way.
Sure.
And be more accepting of people making choices and having to live with them in a really big way. I mean, I've never been, I love to have a glass of wine, but I've never been into drugs. It's never been my thing.
Sure.
But I think it gave me a better perspective through the whole story and the journey and all the people we met with him on how someone can go down that path and to really be much more accepting that it can happen so easily to anybody. And that's why I think the message of the story is so profound, because anyone can take a turn at any time.
It's true.
And it can change your life.
Absolutely.
And that's what this film really was. And I what you said is so true. With documentary film is so organic. What you set out on a mission, you think you know this missive, you know what you want to do, it never ends up being what you set out to originally shoot.
It's funny that way. It is.
And that's the beauty of it. I mean, really, truly, it allows the story to come through instead of you trying to make something out of nothing.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's my experience has been that it's a lot. You shoot and you shoot and you shoot, and then you get back to the editing bay, and then you got to find the story in that. And
completely.
Usually what starts forming is not what you thought you were going to wind up with.
It's, no.
You know, one other thing that I thought was interesting, just doing the research on this, you, not only is there now a film that people can see about his story, but
yes,
apparently there is an album that has been made.
That's, I think, probably the coolest result of this film for Jade, truly. Besides his story being told and to be able to get it out to a wider audience, I think the thing that Jade created, his lyrics, he writes the most profound lyrics, and he's now had a chance through professional musicians to actually track. We have an original score for the entire film, all created by Jade. And Jade was involved in the entire process. So we had artists come out. He was there the whole time. He had massive input in how the music would sound. And he is so particular because he has so little to express. This is such a huge part of his heart and soul is the music.
Yeah.
And I mean, Harpoon Soul, which is the title of our film, is the title track. And it, the story and the narrative through that, it's unbelievable because it's truly his journey as he was going in, as he lost his cognizance, as he went into a coma when he did his speedball.
Was the album something that was planned prior to the documentary, or did it come out as a result of the documentary?
It was, again, an organic, you know, evolution of the film, and we were able to then pull together artists and make this happen.
And now, where is the film screening? When and where is the film screening here at the festival?
It is on Sunday at 4:00 at the community center, at the House of Dogs.
All right, fantastic. And what is the? Maybe I've already asked this question, but I mean, what is it like showing this to audiences that have never heard of Jade?
I think the coolest thing really is, I mean, I actually live here in Sonoma, so, and I travel a lot. So it's really, coming here and being home for the festival is really important to me. I think Kevin McNeely has done a remarkable job at really pulling together a lot of really interesting talent. And Kevin Cathal, the programmer, brought in some great, I've seen some great films already. And it's great to be home, and it's great to be here to show it in an audience of friends and people that are just coming in to see films.
Well, that is fantastic. I want to thank you so much for taking time out of your festival to come and join us here.
Pleasure.
I want to encourage everybody to come see this film. I think you're going to learn a lot. I'm looking forward to seeing it myself.
Thank you.
Kimberley, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. I hope you
enjoy your time here at the Sonoma International Film Festival.
Thanks, you too. Enjoy.
Thanks.